Okay, this is two geldings playing over a fence here. I think this is Buddy and Bick. Buddy likes Bick. They used to be pasture mates years ago. And so what they're doing here is they're reaching through and biting, and he's pawing. See Buddy trying to show dominance? This is how horses learn how to be stallions and how to be dominant. One's going to push, the other one's going to push back. They're going to bite, they're going to take turns. A lot of head movement. A lot of who's going to get higher. You notice Bick's head keeps hitting his head higher. Buddy's a little bit lower. That's showing a little submissive. Buddy's going to try to get his head higher. This is all normal horse playing right here. People want to run over here right now and say, oh my God, those horses are going to bite each other, going to kill each other. Let's save them. Let's block them. Let's put a wall. Now, Buddy just went over to this little young one right here, this little young little mare. And she turned her butt and said, hey, don't bite me. I don't want to play. Mares aren't quite as playful as geldings. So when you get geldings together, they're going to play a lot. And what a lot of people don't realize is there's not geldings out in the wild. There's only stallions and mares. So we throw geldings in a mix, and we have total different herd behavior. We have total different herd dynamics. Buddy's pawing. He's trying to show dominance. He's trying to show how strong and how he can strike. He's pounding the ground. Now he's going to get higher. Bick says, keep your head low, and I'm going to come in. So he's going to paw. Bick's going to try to come in, get a little nip. He's going to turn his butt, threaten. These horses are playing. A lot of people think, oh my God, I get called sometimes. Your horse is fighting. These horses aren't fighting. This is playing. Know the difference. You got some ear pinning. You got some pushing. So horses do. One horse pushes, the other one yields or pushes back. And the more you watch and observe horses, the more you're going to be able to act like a horse and think like a horse when you're dealing with your horse. And then you won't be saying like all these other crazy people out here, my horse kicked me for no reason, my horse is mean, he pinned his ears, the horse is crazy, and all these other silly things that go out there. Horses are horses, and that's all they know how to be. And the more you understand them, the more you observe them, the more you watch them interact with other horses, then you learn how to be a horse, how to think like a horse, how to act like a horse, and your relationship and your ability to train and work with your horse gets a whole lot better. So that's a couple geldings playing, showing dominance, and just being horses. There we go. A little threatening kick, a little bite, a little ear pin. These guys just play. And either one of these horses could walk away. And they don't, because they're playing. This is how they learn for later. I mean, you get a couple boys that are 8, 10 years old, and all they want to do is play. They got all this energy. Well, that's what horses do. And what do? As humans, we want to lock them up. We want to put a blanket on them so they don't get bit. We want to put a fly mask on them so a horse won't bite them and pull their fur off. We want to protect them and put them in a stall. Let horses be horses. If you notice, Buddy's got a whole bunch of bites all over him. He's got different colors. That's just a horse being a horse. I don't want a pretty horse that's never... There it goes. All right, there's a little threatening kick. There's a little threatening kick. And these guys do this if there wasn't a fence there. This just gets a little bit more dangerous with a fence because one of them get their leg caught or one of them go over. Luckily, these fences are good and solid. They're not going to hurt. They're not hurting anything. But watch horses play. Watch how they communicate. Watch how they push and how they move away and how they yield to pressure. Those are things that are going to help you understand horses better. That'll make you a better horseman.